I am Gopinath, advocate practicing the High Court Madras. We're having a very enlightening and stormy session today. I must personally thank on behalf of all the audience, Dr. Zakir Naik. Two small things thrown in my mind. One thing, why Islam prescribed non-vegetarian diet? Another one, whether politicians can dab into religion, whether religion can independently survive without leaving on politics.
So brother, there are two questions. The second question is with politics and Islam. Can religion survive without politics? Brother, as I said, Islam is a complete way of life. There is politics in Islam, but it's not similar to the modern politics that we have, you know. Everyone filling the pockets, etc. So Islam is against such modern politics. But there is a political system in Islam. As I said, Islam is a complete code of conduct. It's a complete way of life. You cannot be a good Muslim without being a good worldly human being. You have to be. So even Islam speaks about politics, that's a different field. But surely what I refer to modern politics, Islam is far away from that. Islam doesn't encourage this politics. Where they scratch people's back and they try and fill their pockets. Their pocket is more important than other people's betterment. Islam is against that. Regarding your first question, which is a very important question, especially since we're having dinner now, after the question and session, the brothers pose the question, why does Islam say that you should have non-veg? Why does Islam allow non-veg? That's a very good question. If you analyze, brother, the set of teeth of the herbivorous animal, the cow, the goat, the sheep, they have got flat set of teeth. They can only have vegetables. If you analyze the set of teeth of the carnivorous animal, the lion, the leopard, the tiger, they have pointed set of teeth. They have only non-veg. If you analyze the set of teeth of the human beings, we have got flat teeth as well as pointed teeth. We have carnivorous as well as herbivorous. We have an omnivorous set of teeth. If God Almighty, our creator, wanted us to have only vegetables, we would have given only flat teeth. Why did he give us pointed teeth? There's a purpose. Even if you thrust down the throat of goat, sheep, cow, the herbivorous animal, non-veg, it will not digest. The digestive system cannot digest. Similarly, the digestive system of the carnivorous animal cannot digest vegetables. The digestive system of the human being can digest both non-veg and veg. If God Almighty wanted us to have only vegetable, why did he give us the digestive system that can digest both? If you analyze the Hindu scriptures, if you read, they said the sages and sons, they had non-veg. It's mentioned there. Even if you read the Ramayana, so again I'm quoting, always give the reference, people should not think I'm pulling a fast one. I'm not pulling a fast one because I give references. People, when I give information to Muslims, they get shocked at mentioning the Quran and Hadith. When I mention about Ramayana and Vedas to non-Muslims, they get shocked. It is mentioned in Ayodhya Khandam, chapter number 90, chapter number 26, that when Ram was sent for Banvas, he told to his mother, I will have to sacrifice my tasty meat dishes. That means Ram ate non-veg. He ate meat. The reason why the Hindu philosophy later on changed to vegetarian is a reason. There has to be a reason. Because people were being influenced by the ahimsa of the other ways of life, Buddhism, Jainism, etc., which believes in ahimsa. So to prevent people from converting to other religion, they accepted vegetarian. Now if you analyze, when you ask these Jains and all, that why do you have only vegetables? They tell you that, see, plants are without life. Animals are with life. Therefore, killing any living creature is wrong. And I agree with it. If you have to kill any living creature without a cause, it is haram even in Islam. If you kill any living creature, let it be an ant also, without a cause, it is not allowed in Islam. But they have a misconception that plants don't have life. Today science has advanced and we have come to know that even plants have got life. So their reason has failed. So they have come out with a new answer saying that, see, the plants do have life, but they can't feel pain. The animals can feel pain. Therefore, killing an animal is a greater crime as compared to killing a plant. Today science is advanced and we have come to know the plants can feel pain. They can even cry. They even feel happy. You know? They have a nervous system, but it will develop. There is research in America that a farmer had an equipment that the cry of the plant can't be heard by human beings because the frequency of the human ear is from 20 cycles to 20,000 cycles per second. You know silent dog whistle? The dog can hear till 40,000 cycles per second. So when you blow the dog whistle, human beings can't hear, but the dog comes to the master. So human beings can only hear from 20 cycles to 20,000 cycles per second. Maybe the cry that the plant gives, it is out of the range. So a farmer took out an equipment in which the moment the plant didn't get water, it cried and it could hear it. So plants can feel pain, they even feel happy, they can even cry. So there was a person who had the maximum argument with me and he said, "See, Brother Zakir, I agree with you that plants are living creatures, they can feel pain. But you see, if you analyze logically, the animals, they have got 5 senses. The plants, they have got 2 or 3 senses. So killing a living creature which has got 5 senses is a greater crime than killing a living creature which has got 3 senses. Logical. I, for sake of argument, agree with you. Suppose your brother, he is born deaf and born dumb. And when he grows up, if a criminal comes and murders him, will you go and tell the judge, "Oh my Lord, give the murderer less punishment because my brother had 2 senses less"? Will you say that? You will say, "Give the murderer a bigger punishment. The poor person couldn't support himself." So in Islam it is, you can... In Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse 168, "Eat of the good things they have provided." But a Muslim can be a very good Muslim even by being a pure veg. He can be. Not that he can't be. Quran does not say you should have non-veg. You can be a good Muslim even by being a pure vegetarian. But if you analyze, there is no first class proteins in vegetarian. Do you know that? The best protein of vegetables is soya bean, which is second class. The non-veg have the first class protein, which is not in vegetables. There are articles coming written by scientists who say that these are the benefits of vegetarian or non-veg. They are promoting vegetarian because it's their way of life. But there are articles written by non-vegetarian scientists also which disprove that. So when you have a person who has knowledge of both non-veg and veg, you will come to know that eating non-veg is beneficial for the human body. So Allah has given us good food which you can have. Why should you abstain from it? Hope that answers the question.